Hello and welcome to our review of Spider-Man Homecoming.
So just to let you know, this will be a spoiler-free review as the movie has just come out and we don't want to ruin it for people who haven't seen it. So first of all, we're going to talk about the story. The story is really sort of well done, fleshed out. There's not a huge amount of stakes in it, but that's kind of leveled out by just being a friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
They really keep the story centered around like the Queens area where Spider-Man lives, because obviously we have all these other characters like the Avengers doing the sort of big save the world things. So it's really refreshing to see Spider-Man dealing with something that's not too big of an issue, but it's big enough for him to handle. It doesn't get too crazy.
Another thing this movie does really well is it sort of includes Peter's school life, so like him trying to balance being Spider-Man and also going to school, which is sort of a new take on the character that we haven't really got in previous versions. I mean, Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man was sort of a little bit in high school but on his way out basically, and obviously Tobey Maguire was just sort of graduating. So yeah, this is a really sort of interesting and more sort of comic book
accurate representation, version. Right? Yeah, we've never really sort of seen this before.
So character-wise, everyone in this movie is really strong. The sort of chemistry is really there with all of them. You believe they go to school together, yeah. All the younger cast. So obviously we have Tom Holland for his second appearance as Peter Parker / Spider-Man, and yeah, he's just as likable as he was in Civil War, maybe a little bit more because you get more of his like home stuff and more of just the character. Yeah. He's really, really well played. There's some good comedy in there, some good emotion. I think he's sort of good cocktail of what we've liked about Spider-Man in other movies.
He gets the balance of the sort of cocky, jokey Spider-Man along with the totally nerdy, totally socially awkward Peter Parker. And the two really mesh really well. And the Spider-Man isn't too cocky. He's not like a typical Spider-Man bully, kind of how Andrew Garfield was in The Amazing Spider-Man. He goes into situations still not knowing what he's doing. So Jacob Batalon plays Peter Parker's best mate, Ned. And they have great sort of chemistry, and you really believe that they are the nerds, they're the outcasts. And not to keep comparing it to like previous Spider-Man films, but I think where Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man failed was he felt like he could be cool. Whereas these two are very clearly, they're outcasts, they are nerds, and they constantly get called that.
Another supporting character in the movie is obviously Tony Stark. Robert Downey Jr. returns for like the 15th millionth time in a movie. And he's really good. I was really worried that Tony Stark would be in it too much. But I feel like he's in it enough that you know he's there and you know the rest of the Avengers exist.
Yeah, good balance.
But he never really steals any scenes.
He doesn't outstay his welcome. It's definitely a Spider-Man film. It's not Spider-Man and Iron Man, or Iron Man and Spider-Man. It's Spider-Man, but Tony Stark shows up sometimes.
Michael Keaton playing the Vulture is a really good villain, actually. He is sort of fleshed out. There's reason behind everything he's doing. He's quite intense and quite menacing at certain points in the movie, and yeah.
There are some very threatening scenes with him. I would like to see a bit more characterization of him. It still kind of falls into that grey area of Marvel villains being kind of generic, but he's a bit more interesting than previous ones because he gets a bit more screen time. In fact, the first scene of the film sets up the character and you get a bit of a backstory there.
One thing this movie does really well is it's sort of action-based stuff. Nothing's ever too fast, nothing's cut too quickly, you can always really tell what's going on. It's actually really entertaining in the way that they try and figure out new sort of ways of having Spider-Man fight. Like, he's got all these new abilities, so let's actually use them and make a interesting sequence out of that.
It's quite interesting in this, in that Spider-Man often, it feels like he doesn't have control of the situation, whereas in previous films he seems a bit like he knows what he's doing from the start, whereas in this he does fall flat on his face, he does make mistakes, he's a novice essentially, and it's just interesting to see how he deals with being basically terrible at his job. So an issue I kind of had with the film was that some of the CG was quite obvious, most notably the CG Spider-Man. Certain acrobatics he does are probably not easy to do for an actor. The physics seem a bit off and it just looks a little bit uncanny valley, I thought. I don't know if you agree, but
I didn't personally see anything wrong with that.
Especially when he's well lit as well, some of it seemed a bit too CG for me.
So, Sam, would you recommend this movie to anyone? And if so, who?
I'd recommend it to people that enjoyed Spider-Man and Civil War. If you're sort of a bit burned out from Spider-Man, you might enjoy this film. It is a bit, it's a different take. You get a bit of a different look on Spider-Man. It doesn't feel samey in the same way that Amazing Spider-Man kind of retreaded what happened in the original Spider-Man film. This is different because it's set in a shared universe of, like, Spider-Man is no longer the most powerful person in New York City. He's just an amateur novice who's trying to be the other heroes. And I just think that makes for a very interesting dynamic. And if you enjoy Spider-Man for the comics, even, I think you would appreciate this more than previous Spider-Man films. So, Neil, would you recommend this to anyone?
I would recommend this to pretty much anyone. It's a fresh take on Spider-Man. It's a sort of more modern Spider-Man. It's more believable. There's a lot more to the character. Like, it's not an origin story, which I think is really important. I think we all know that he gets bit by a spider and then Uncle Ben dies and his parents are already dead. We don't necessarily care about that. It wouldn't be emotionally impacting for us to see that again. I think it's a very strong movie and I laughed a lot during it.
So that was our review of Spider-Man Homecoming. Let us know what you thought of the film if you are watching this review after seeing the film. Let us know if you are excited for the film. And please, you know, keep it spoiler free. Because obviously, if some people are watching this review to see if they want to see it, then they don't want it spoiled. So we appreciate it.
If you're watching this review, go and see the movie instead, because it's good.
Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to leave a like and smack subscribe. And thank you very much. Cheers.
This broadcast was filmed in front of a live studio, Max.
Hey.
it's entertainment, blah, blah, blah.
It's entertainment.
You pay to see this.
What more do you want?